Good afternoon, everyone. This is Tube 87. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you have a happy and a blessed Sabbath. Now, today's study or today's lesson is going to be on the rewards of obedience. And I just want to spend a few minutes talking about what I like to refer to as a few principles about obedience and its rewards. Now, one thing we have to understand, as always, there's something we have to understand. We have to do what the Father wants us to do fully. We can't just do part of it or partially do what He's telling us. Obedience is doing what the Father says, when He says it, and how He tells us to do it. That's what we're supposed to do in its entirety. Now, we don't have to understand how, why, or anything about it. If He says to do it, we should just do it, because He is always looking out in our best interest. So we shouldn't question anything that doesn't seem rational or logical that the Father wants us to do. Remember, this is about our salvation. This is about our obedience. This is about heaven. That's what it's all about. This is where we're trying to go. He always rewards obedience, but failure to obey the Father will always bring pain and suffering. Now, the suffering or the reward may not be evident immediately in any of our lives, but you can be rest assured that it will come, either the joy of reward or the pain of your suffering. So always understand that and keep it in mind. Don't ever think we've gotten away with anything and that we won't suffer for it. And don't ever think that because we've done or we're doing what we're supposed to do that we won't be rewarded. Everything is always on His time and not ours. So this is already teaching us a lesson in what? Patience. Faithfulness. Be faithful and be patient. Those two things are being covered in something as simple as that. Now, our motivation to be obedient should never be for reward. We should be obedient, one, because He's the Heavenly Father, Yahweh. He deserves it. Secondly, He's wise and He only requires the best for us. And thirdly, because of our love and devotion to Him should be reason enough for us to just be obedient and do whatever it is He wants us to do. So ask yourself this question: what is the Father telling me to do? Am I doing what He's telling me to do? Or am I just dipping and dabbing and doing part of it? Or not at all? Am I ignoring what I should be doing? Ask yourself these questions and then look at your life. Do you have a lot of pain and suffering in your life? Do you have things going on in your life? Or are you just being blessed and you're doing what you're supposed to do? Whatever the case may be, take every opportunity to be obedient to His word and what He expects of us, so that we will receive the rewards. Now, some of the principles I want to go over right quick. I think there are about five of them I want to go over right quick. First, we have to understand that our needs are often opportunities for the Father to give us lessons in obedience. So whatever that dire situation is, be it an illness, be it a loss, it could even be a loss of a loved one, a financial woe, things like this are opportunities for us to be obedient to the Father. We have to have patience, we have to have faith, we have to do what He wants us to do. And He will reward us. He will get us through whatever the situation is. We're always going to be tested, like I always say. Now, situations in our lives are primarily created needs. These needs are created. They're created by things being allowed in our lives, or by sometimes the Father Himself. He can create these needs in our lives. And there are opportunities, once again, for us to be obedient. Now, we shouldn't sit around and try and figure out if the Father allowed this through the enemy. See, when He allows stuff, the enemy can go to work. The enemy is always trying to work on us. But those of us who are strong and faithful have less of an opportunity for the enemy to be able to cause us any grief. But those of us who are not doing what we're supposed to do, who are always out of the will of the Father, that allows the enemy ample opportunity to cause all sorts of chaos in our life. So these are needs being created one way or the other. And we shouldn't be spending so much time trying to figure out, did the Father allow this or did the enemy do this? We just need to understand that it's being done, and we need to understand what we need to do to correct it. And that's by being obedient and faithful to the Father. Okay, now number two. Oftentimes, our obedience requires us to do things that appears unreasonable and impractical to ourselves or even other people. But if it's being obedient to the will of the Father, we need to be about our business and do whatever it is, however He says to do it, and whenever He tells us to do it. And that's through His word, or however you receive it, we should do it. Because if we sit around, looking around, seeing what everyone else is doing, and then we choose to do what they do, as opposed to being obedient to the Father, we're disobeying Him. We're being disobedient. Everyone is not going to be told to do what it is the Father tells you to do. Everyone is not in His will, but you need to stay in His will. Okay, number three, we have to understand that our failure to obey the Father will cost us the things we desire most. Remember, He has already provided everything for us. He has already provided all the blessings and desires of our heart for us. But we have to be about His business, being obedient, being faithful, so we can just partake of what He has already stored for us. There's not anything He's waiting to do. It's already been done. Just like the word says, the victory is already ours, but we just have to partake of it. We have to remove things like pride. We can't let our pride get in the way. Being prideful, stubborn, that type of thing. We have to remove anger out of the way. We can't be being angry when we know that we're supposed to be doing something contrary to what we're doing. And our unbelief. We can't doubt, we can't not believe what His word tells us to do. We just have to be about it and do it. Okay, now number four, this is very important. The right counsel always encourages obedience to the Heavenly Father. Number four, this is very important. Right counsel always encourages obedience to the Heavenly Father. So be very careful of the kind of counsel that you listen to. Look, there are many people who don't like to see people hurt or in need, and they'll rush right in to show them or tell them how to take care of themselves. Sometimes they may be interfering with the Father's plan. So be careful that you're not one of these people always rushing in. Mothers, fathers, parents, make sure you're not that kind of parent when it comes to your children, especially adult children off living their lives in their own situations. Be very careful that you're not always rushing in, bailing them out of their situations, taking care of their situations, correcting their problems, helping them fix this and fix that, because you may be interfering with the Father's plan, especially if you claim to be a believer and you understand and know that they're doing things that are not according to the Father's will. But yet, every time there's a situation, you're there to bail them out because you feel a need to have to do that, because you feel like it's the right thing to do. Don't interfere with the Father's plan, and sometimes allow them to go through whatever it is that they need to go through, because if there's a need for them to become obedient once again or to do the Father's will, especially if they've fallen out of the will, you need to let them go through their situation and learn how to call on the Father and learn how to be obedient so that He may help bring them back to Himself and to you, because you serve them no purpose if your role in life is to keep taking care of their problems for them and they never learn, and ultimately it costs them their salvation. So be very careful about that type of helping. And also be careful that when you counsel someone, any of us, when you counsel someone, you always counsel them to obey the Heavenly Father. And you will hear me say it all the time, do things according to the Father's will. And last but not least, the rewards of obedience will strengthen and encourage our faith. So as we're being faithful and doing what's right and being rewarded, if that is not a positive motivator, if that is not encouragement to keep and continually to do what's right, because one, you love the Father, and two, He's going to take care of you and your needs because of it. Always do this and always keep in mind that He is looking out in our best interest. So, with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 287.